Rajesh?
Bhandari.
I knew that. Bhandari. And on respectively on sitar and tabla. And the Irshad's background, he belongs to a family of musicians, and there's in India, North India, they have a tradition called the Gurana tradition where they pass knowledge down, musical knowledge down in families. He's one of the leading sitars in India, and his Gurana is over 400 years old, so he's coming from a tradition that is over 400 years old. It is a classical tradition, and the main point that he wanted to make to me, I believe, was that even though we have these generations of tradition and they really keep the tradition very tight, they also try to push the tradition as well, push it forward. So we think a tradition is something that's static, and it's not necessarily true. Also, he informed me that his playing is all based on emotion. And so what he is going to play today is about his emotion here in this room, with this experience. And of course, everybody is involved with that as well. Anything else?
Sure. That's great introduction.
Okay. All right. So please give your attention.
Thank you very much. We would like to welcome all of you. Do we have some more sound, please? Volume? A little volume, please. Is the volume there? Can you hear me well? Okay. Could we have a little volume, please, for the microphone? This is for the vocals. The master volume can come up, please. Yeah, is that better? Yeah, okay. What I'm doing is I'm right now tuning my instrument. I was fortunate to have inherited this instrument from my dad, but the wood was kept in the family for generations, and the instrument was made like almost 65 years back for my dad actually, and then I kind of represented it down to me. So it's a very special instrument. It's extremely sensitive to the weather. Are you able to hear me well? Can I have a little more volume on my voice, please? A little bit. Is that okay? That's a sitar. That should be okay. I think it'll be okay. Yeah. 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 Tabla? Yeah. Okay, that's better. So let me play something for you and then we can talk or, you know, have a question answers and see how it goes today. Now in music we have a tonic, which is in my sitar, I'm using the C sharp as my tonic. And the notes that we have in Indian classical music are the same as you have, the same seven notes as you have in the Western form, which is the language is so the notes are the same, but the way we apply these notes is different. In a sense, you will see the phrasings that I'll be doing is very different. So I'll be starting, I'll play something in Grace came, which is, I'll be starting with like a folk song which was written in the 13th century by a great Sufi philosopher who was like a mystical, Islamic mystical saint. His name was Amir Khusru. He wrote the song, now I'll be improvising in that song for you. So altogether I have about 18 strings and so 6 strings on top and about 12 sympathetic strings. And I tune these strings according to the raga or the piece, the musical piece that I'm playing. As you can see, these sympathetic strings are being tuned in the major scale mostly. I can bend 5 notes from a single note, but then the secret is the accent of the bend. The bend has to be in a very special, very sophisticated form. That's how you learn from a proper master of sitar, and then you learn how to bend. It's not just your bending for the sake of bending, but there's a meaning behind each and every phrase that I'll be playing. I'm improvising with the song, but every phrase that I'm improvising or saying, it's like a conversation. It has a meaning why it's there. Not just because I want to just play a phrase. So it's like a conversation, you know, a meaningful conversation. With every phrase that I would play or bend, it could have a meaning to that music. And then, in my style especially, I don't play the notes straight. Like, he's playing You're welcome. Thank you. That was just like a spark of what we do in a concert. You just heard. It was just like a little taste of it, you know. The real food is usually when we are in a concert situation, when we are elaborating a raga. A rag is a melodic structure, so we have this whole tradition of raga music in the North Indian tradition of classical music in India. And these rags are melodic themes. And we have many different types of rags. We have rags for the morning, we have rags for the evening, we have the ragas for the midnight, so we have seasonal rags and rags for all different times of the day. So basically, we choose a rag for a particular time of the day, and then we have a set composition, and then we improvise in the rag according to, I mean, I'm talking about a proper master musician. You know, that's what, when he masters, and then that's what he does. Like, for my, in myself, like, all my life I've been playing the sitar, and it's been in my genes, this music. Because for the last 400 years, you know, my forefathers, they were like legends in India. They're like icons in the world of North Indian classical music. The whole, all this sitar technique and, you know, has been derived in my family for hundreds of years. So basically, sitar players all over the world, they follow our family's technique, and my family, this name, the famous Khan family, is known, just named after my great grandfather. It's called the Imdad Khan Gharana. Gharana means the traditional school. So this is one of the iconic families of sitar. So basically, we are known as the purest as well as sitar. But when I come to the West, I also do a lot of kind of fusion where I'm collaborating with.